So I am going to create a poster. I already created one earlier, so I'm going to probably use that one. No, I'm just going to start over. Don't save. File new. I want 3 artboards. 24 inches by 36 inches. No bleeds. CMYK high res. There's my artboards. I think I'll rearrange those artboards real quick because I don't like them next to each other. I'm going to go to my properties panel. Edit artboards. Rearrange. I want them going up and down. Well, maybe side by side. With a little bit more spacing in between. Maybe 1.25 inches. Click OK. So now I've got some nicely organized artboards to start with. I don't need my layers right now. I don't need that. I do need my character palette. And I'll keep my properties panel over here. I'm going to go to the assignment. And I'm going to grab all that information that is required. Event details, that's what I need basically. Just go ahead and copy all that. I'll probably make a QR code out of this link just for my design. They will be providing a QR code. So don't forget that QR code's going to be on there. Paste that in, make it bigger so I can see it. And I'm just going to cut this apart and put it in separate boxes so I can put it where I want it on the first poster. In fact, let me go ahead and add QR code to this so you don't forget it. So at the bottom with the logos, we're going to put QR code at least. How big? About at least 1.5 inches, 1.5 inches square. And I'll put will be provided and submit. All right. I'm just going to work, play a little music if that's all right. Thank you. absolutely sure to place your images into your workspace. Don't drag and drop. You need to have links when you're finished. And I'm looking in those folders to make sure there are links. So I'm looking up a couple of logos here just for fillers. And I'm dragging them to my desktop first, dropping them off, and then placing them into my document. But I will be providing you with these logos. I just wanted to put something online just so I can have it. That one's got a P. That's probably the one I'm going to share with you right there. It's a PNG with a clear background. So I'm going to place those two logos. And maybe I'll add them to the assignment here before the end of the class. I don't like the white background, so I'll probably get rid of that white background or something. Better look. I don't like my backgrounds and logos, especially if I've got a dark background. So I've got that. Three events, join us. Time, date, location. Out of this case examples. Just popping everything over, getting it out of here. Illinois, Samuel. Now I've got the bones of my poster. I'm not even worried about imagery right now. I want to start playing around with the font choices, the feel. And once I'm done with that, then I'll start looking at imagery and I can always adjust things from there. So I know this needs to go at the top, so I'm going to go ahead and put it at the top. This needs to be gigantic. So I'm going to bring that down just a tiny bit. This needs to be 100 points. Probably be that. This is the most boring font there is, so I'll probably fix that up shortly. I just want to get things placed where I want them. I'm going to use my alignment tools to center things on the page. Super important. And I'm starting out with symmetrical, but that may change after I look at some images to see what is going to work with this. So just make sure everything's nicely centered. And the hierarchy is how far is too long to be a lot bigger. That's our headline. So just doing a basic font poster to start with, and I can get more elaborate, maybe more artistic on the second one. Get things in the positions that they need to be in. This case exam. Center that. Oops. Center. I think in your properties panel it's all right there. So use your alignment tool for the properties panel if that's easier for you. I want to look at the sentence structure on this one. I don't want it to be broken, I want it to be perfect. So I'm going to pull this to the edges and read it so it reads clearly. This case examines a man's claim to First Amendment protection. Maybe return after making threatening online comments, asserting his comments were an artistic expression as an aspiring rapper. So just that word rapper has given me a new guide in direction, artistic direction. Maybe this could take a kind of a really modern rap kind of feel to it, right? I don't know how to do that, so I probably need to start going and looking up how to a rap poster, or how do they do it, you know? Teach yourself how to do something different. Alignment, join us, it's a free event. That's at the bottom. That is not what needs to be right at the top. Got the two logos that have got to be there, and the last thing on the page is going to be designed by. The post and the logos symmetrical as well. I draw myself a guide to get those logos right on the same line. So if it will tech on there, and I want to push this down to get it right on that line too, because it is transparent. So now they look similar. Might bump them up a little bit. Free event. Maybe I'll go and look up some cool graphics for free events. Free events. Just type in Word, see what other people have done. This is how I do a lot of my stuff. It gives me inspiration. That's kind of nice. I could make that. Or I could go to Free Pick and buy it or download it, right? Doesn't have to be an original illustration. But if I pick this one, for instance, I like that and I found it on Freebie, I would want to keep things artistically similar throughout. Not exactly the same, but similar. This is kind of nice. I like that. Okay, kind of teared, torn, flipped paper look. So just because of that inspiration, I'm going to go ahead and go to Free Pick and give it a shot. See if I can find something with a, let's do vectors and free peeling paper. It's giving me torn paper. What would I call that? Well, how would I search this? Anybody? Like this. Corner peel, maybe? That's what I want right there. Peel, corner peel. And I may use it, I may not. I need to make sure I get free ones. Search again. What I'm looking for right there. Download. Open it up. I'm going to open this with Illustrator. Open the EPS with Illustrator. I don't want to place the EPS because it won't work properly. I want to open the EPS and I want to copy one of these things into my document. So it says free event. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to leave it open in case I want to try a different one. And paste. Make it a little bit bigger. Holding my shift key. So I don't know if I really want that. No, it doesn't really go. But I'll keep it here just in case. Maybe free event. I want to make it probably white because it's going on the red background. Font is just really bad, so I'm trying to find something a little bit more similar. That's too fun. Something a little bit serious. And you know, corporate free is too serious. That's cool, but it's not Halloween yet. That's scary. Free event. You don't want to go too scary. This is a serious event. Tiny, tiny details all end up in the end. There, that looks pretty good. I like that. I like to put my text boxes in so they don't get in the way. Free event. And maybe join us could be up here somewhere by the date. Join us Tuesday, March 11th. Tony Rambert from the Purpose Room. So my first poster is, it's got everything I need on it except for a photograph. This is where I'm going to start with the imagery. I'm not going to play with the text just yet with fonts, choices, and things like that because I don't have a feel yet or a feel. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the images. See where I'm going to. Currently, I have two links. They have automatically embedded, which I shouldn't have done that. So because I didn't click on the link down here at the bottom of the place panel, they automatically embedded, so I don't want that to happen. So I'm going to select both of them and tell them to link those. That way they will be linked when I pack them up. So I'm going to trash those other ones and replace them with these. Want them to be linked. Fable Tech is priority. Couple of County Lover is second. Next, so let's go free pick or pixels or wherever you'd like to find your artwork. See what we can find. Try lots of different. I'm looking for a scared woman. I don't think this is going to work. These are all illustrations. These are vectors, not the kind of feel I'm going for. So I need to do a new search for photos. Try it again. I'm looking for a really scary, ominous woman. These are all kind of goofy. So that's telling me that prepic doesn't have what I want. And if you look in the assignment, those resources are available in the side tab. Scared woman. This is looking better. This is already getting the feel that I want right here. This is just one idea. It might be helpful if I know who Alonis is as well. Is he white? Is he Hispanic? Is he black? I don't know. That way I can figure out what his wife is, so I can be a little bit more accurate. So his wife, right here. Anthony Alonis. All right, let's type in Anthony Alonis' wife. I want to see what she looks like. They don't have a picture of her only because she's being protected, I would assume. Led me to a whole different little bit. Research here. So this is him. So I'm probably going to go with a more subliminal woman that you can't see her face or her ethnicity because I don't know who she is. So maybe a silhouette. Type in code instead. Not getting what I need there. That's cool. This is kind of where I'm going, but I'm not having much trouble finding it. This woman sitting in the dark. Let's That would be an awesome magazine cover, wouldn't it? Vogue, Vogue. That'd be a good picture for my poster. Just kidding. That's pretty good. Now I see the other stuff talking about the campaign. We got this free picture. All right. Let's do it. At some point, I've got to give up and just get something on the page and start playing around. I've spent hours looking at this photograph, so I'm going to start with that. Knowing more about the case would be helpful too, so maybe we get this more clarity tomorrow. Yeah. Interesting. Let's see if he's got some more than I do. Ooh, that looks good. There, found it. So if I click on this one that has the same kind of vibe that I like, and I could probably I could have got my own model of particular studio where you're always looking to do that, but I'm looking for something similar to this. I want to see your face. So I'm thinking I might just go with, I'm going to go with this one. Just for now. So I downloaded it as a JPEG in my file place. I'll add some black to the bottom and chop her up. I'm going to go into view trim so I can see what this is going to look like. wall. In fact, I'm going to put one time with a rectangle tool, and I want it 24 inches by 36 inches. So it literally drew me a shape that size, which is my life. Object clipping mask make. So now I just have a picture and it's not a bunch of size stuff on the sides. Now I can start thinking about what can I put on there. I'm definitely going to have to change the color of my text because it's not going to work as black, it will disappear. Eventually, this will be a finished poster. I just want to use it for now just to get some stuff on this other one because I don't. Inspired and creative to make this work. Kerning on this is super, super wide. I'm pull it out a little bit, tighten it just a little bit. And then just the letting. How far is too far? And I'll probably try these in multiple different colors to see what I like. Soft gray, white, pink, not. I think red's a bit too much, so I'm going to go with soft gray for now. And this is just the beginning. I think I should put too far off one place. Tighten the letting and the letting my kernel. I think I make this bigger. This information over so I can see it. And this background is driving me insane, so I'm going to lock it through something else on my air. It just keeps getting in the way. So I'm going to click on that background, click a new layer, move it to a new layer for the background, and move that layer to the bottom, and lock it. Now it won't move anymore, and I can do what I need to do. Maybe I don't want how far is too far to be the main focus. Maybe I want Ilonis versus the U.S. I don't know yet. That's what it's all about, figuring that out. Sense out, put it in its own box, that way I have control over it a little bit better. Maybe put a nice cursive on that. Go to my filters and click on cursive. It's going to give me those cursive examples. That's a bit too fancy. I want something classy and professional. Chancery. It's got to be the ugliest font they ever created. It also needs to be legible, right? We've got to make sure we can see it. These are all a bit too fancy. I'm going to get rid of the script and just go back to a same font. There we go. That's what I need. Center it on the page with my alignment tool. sizes and the weights. So we have a multitude of fonts on the page, just very, very few, two if possible, and combinations of those two. One like this one, because I got too many fonts on the set. This is looking pretty good. I think it's a different color. I don't like this font now. It's just too grungy. It's not serious enough for me. So let's just ignore that for now. Keep on. Yeah, I would like this information, but I don't want it so big and wide. I want to put it up in a paragraph like this. And then left align it. And maybe there's something that's called full quotes that I really like. New window and I look up some full quotes to get a good design. So full quotes are these little things, how they pull information out, make you read it before you even look at anything else. And they do it in lots of different ways, sometimes with box colors, sometimes with different font choices. I really like this one. So since I don't need this as a link, I'm just going to drag it into my document for reference. And I can maybe see if this is where I want. And I'm going to continue looking. I'm going to go to free pick and look up some full quotes. Free vectors. Full quote. Same thing, a little bit different. Lots of different options here. I don't have to reinvent the wheel when I'm designing for somebody. I just need to make it balanced and harmonious. So this is definitely too casual. But maybe I can find something that I can use here, and if not, I can make them. Just building. Oh, I like that. That's nice. Look at that one. That will work. Let me download that. I can make that myself too, but why don't I download it? Open it up. Open the Illustrator or EPS file with Illustrator. I'm working in Illustrator already. I can copy and paste this. So I kind of like this square one, but I really like these quotation marks. So I'm going to grab, all of it, copy it, put it into my poster. So I've got it on the side there if I need it. And that's where I'll put the, with this. And this kind of incorporates this example that I have as well on the screen. So I could use, I don't like these quotation marks, or these, oh, they have a box there for a reason, because they don't know how to use a sheet holder tool, I guess. Trash, trash. I'll do those, and a little bit smaller. I'm going to trash what I don't need. I'll pull this over here. So these are, they are vector. I'm going to get my shape builder tool so I can make these literally white if I want to. So I'm going to get my shape builder right here. And I'm going to click in each of these little quotations and get rid of that one. Click here, shape builder. I want to make these into shapes, and it's turning red because I have red fill. Now I'm going to do an option to get that negative sign. Trash. So thankfully my background is locked. Where can I put this? right, I'm going to unlock the background. I'm going to flip her. Select the object, transform, reflect. So she's now in the other direction, which is going to help my layout a little bit more. Pop that layer back. And I think these rotation marks are the wrong way. So I'm going to flip those as well. There we go. That's how they go. So now I've got this. So I want to put that information down here into this box. It might be a bit too much information, though, for a poster that's going to be on the street. So maybe I will take all this text, select all, and maybe I'll go to ChatGPT and simplify this a little bit. And I can do that by just telling it to simplify into one sentence. And then paste my information. And here we go. This case explored whether the man is threatening all my comments, which he calls artistic expression as rap object. That is not good. Threats or art? So I just asked you to give me a list of variations for threat or art, because it's all about, is it a threat or was it considered artistic expression? And it gave me all this stuff in that, like menace or masterpiece, intimidation or expression, violence or vision. So maybe I could take this list of stuff to the meeting and see if they'd be interested in using any of it. Fear or freedom of speech. Hostility or artistry. Let's do outrage. Copy. Paste. Outrage or originality. Oh, it's time already. Wow. So when you get to class tomorrow, we'll work on our poster for an hour, then we're going to walk over and visit our client. Hopefully we'll have a few more people join us, or they'll be way behind on this project. Well, I'm pretty much done with the recordings, and we have them for Thursday and Monday. So tomorrow would just be a work day and the quiz. So yeah, and then we've got till Thursday to do that. Yeah. Okay. All right, honey. You're welcome. refresh. Wait. Excuse me. Have a good one. That was a total accident that just happened right here, my stroke. But it looks too comic-y. It looks too much fun. So let's fix it. I need to round the edges of that stroke. All right, class is done. I'm going to save and I'm going to close this Collaborate for tomorrow. Close. Close. Thank you, too, hon. All right, stop recording.